exploring deep space tonight with the most ambitious mission since man walked on the moon. The Rosetta space probe will touch down on a comet. Australian space launch engineer Warwick Holmes was there when Rosetta was built and fired into space, and he's on our couch now. Now, this has taken an amazing 12 years. What's actually happening tonight?
Tonight is the end of the mission. This is when we put the orbiter spacecraft Rosetta down onto the surface of the comet as well. We've been following the comet for 2 years. Total distance of 1.5 billion kilometres following the comet.
Wow.
But the total distance we've travelled since we launched is 8 billion kilometres.
Oh, my God.
And you've actually got a replica of that comet.
This is a model of the comet. This is a 3D printed version of the comet. You can actually get that from our website.
Oh, it's smaller than I expected.
It's a bit ugly, though, isn't it?
It hasn't been to makeup, I'm sorry.
And it's not quite to scale, is it? The real comet? How big's the real comet?
The real comet is 4 by 3 by 2 kilometres. It's a very strange shape, but it would fit nicely between Anzac Bridge and Sydney Harbour Bridge.
Oh!
Very, very small.
So if it comes crashing down to Earth, that's where...
We know where to put it, yeah.
And it is an unusual shape, though, because I always think of a comet being this lovely round sphere.
Well, that's what we thought, too. Mm. This was an enormous shock. It's actually two comets joined together. Okay, now this turned out to be an enormous surprise because it was formed way out past Pluto. This is where all this cometary material was first formed. And two of them drifted together. And this is extremely unusual because they're meant to be so far apart.
Oh.
So this was part of the benefit of the mission, was finding this amazing science.
And tell us just a bit about this project, because this just blows my mind. So you built a spacecraft to basically go chasing a comet 8 billion kilometres away, and now it's about to land on the comet. Now, firstly, you actually never thought you'd get to this point, did you? You never thought you'd be able to land this.
Well, when we were building it, there are just lots and lots of problems. It's the first time ever we've done anything so complex. And the software and the hardware, there was a really, really complex box of electronics. So when you're in the clean room every day making it, you know, you're just thinking, this thing's never going to work. You know, it's just so many problems. But, that was our job, was to solve them. Okay. So then we launched it, and as the mission was proceeding, because of the software, we were able to modify things. Okay, so as we were learning more and more about the spacecraft and the mission, we improved it. Okay. It just kept going.
Now, Warwick, I have trouble doing a reverse park. How do you land? How do you land the Rosetta on a comet, which is moving how fast?
Well, the fastest it went was 135,000 kilometres an hour.
Oh.
And that was in August last year. We had to match that speed, and then we put the lander down at only 3 kilometres an hour, so very slowly. But the biggest problem we've got is it's got almost no gravity. It has 1/100,000th of a G.
What does that mean?
So that means that the 2-ton spacecraft weighs 20 grams, which is about a sheet of paper.
And is there someone controlling it from Earth
because it's so far away, the speed of light has a delay of 30 minutes when we did our first landing. Tonight, it's going to be 40 minutes. It's even further away. So we can't do anything in real time. You talk about the reverse park. If you turn your steering wheel, it takes 40 minutes for the wheels to move, okay?
Wow.
And then, another 40 minutes for that reaction to actually come back to you.
Can we explain, just using your tie, because I think this but this simplifies it, that already this thing... That is on the comet.
Yeah, that's Philae, the lander. That came down about 2 years ago.
Yeah.
Okay, so that was designed to do a landing. That had massive instruments in it.
Mm-hmm.
Came down onto the surface and we did some science on the surface. Mm. The orbiter...
And that's the orbiter.
That's the mother spacecraft that carried Philae all that way, the 8 billion kilometres.
Mm-hmm.
Carried Philae. This is coming down on the surface of the comet tonight.
Wow.
So that weighs about 2 tonnes. But it was never designed to land. So that's coming down very slowly as well. And then it will just stay on the surface forever.
My husband is a massive space nerd. He would love a tie like that. Can you buy them somewhere?
In the European Space Agency shop, yes, you can.
Oh, great.
Christmas is sorted, Sarah.
We've managed to land a spaceship on a comet 8 billion kilometres away, and all we want is a tie.
Warwick, what a pleasure to talk to you. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.